Hello class 7, so let us continue chapter number 10, lines and angles, in which we were doing properties of parallel lines. So we will start with question number 3, first part. These are two parallel lines and this is the transversal cutting these two lines. Making an angle 100 degree and an angle of x. You have to find the value of x. Now children, as I've already told you, these two angles which lie on the same side of the transversal and both are on the upper side of the respective lines. 100 degree also on the upper side of this first line. X also on the upper side of this second line. So these types of angles are called as corresponding angles. And the corresponding angles are always equal. That means x is equals to 100 degrees. Simple, because these two are corresponding angles. So the values are same. Now children, you have to mention the reason also. It is compulsory to give the reason along with your answer. Now second part, these two are parallel lines. This is the transversal. Now this is 110 and this is the unknown angle x. Now they are lying on the same side of the transversal, but below this first line and this is above this second line. So these two types of angles are called as co-interior angles. And the sum of co-interior angles is 180 degrees. That means x plus 110 equals to 180 degrees. The reason is that they are co-interior angles. That means x equals to 180 degree minus 110. That comes out to be 70 degrees. That means x is 70 degrees. Now question number 3, third part. These two are parallel lines and the transversal is cutting them. This angle is 110 and you have to find this unknown angle x. Now these two angles have no direct relation to each other. That is why we have to find some another angle through which we can find this value of x. Directly we cannot find x with this 110. So there are two or many ways, like these two, whenever crosses made, these two are vertically opposite angles and they are same. That means if this is 110, this angle is also 110. And now 110 degrees and x are co-interior angles. So what is the sum of co-interior angles? X plus 110 equals to 180 degrees. Okay, children, before this, you can name this angle by any other letter. Suppose you are taking as P. You have to mention this also. P equals to 110 degrees. First of all, you will write they are vertically opposite angles. And now x plus 110 is 180 degree. Now you will mention they are co-interior angles. So x becomes 180 degree minus 110. That means 70 degrees. So x is 70 degrees. Question number 4, first part. Children, you can see the figure from the book given on page number 208. So these two unknown angles are co-interior angles. One angle is 2x plus 6 degree and the other angle is 3x plus 54 degrees. Since they are co-interior angles, so the sum is 180 degrees. That means 2x plus 6 degree plus 3x plus 54 degrees equals to 180 degree. Now we will solve this equation. We will collect the like terms together. So 2x plus 3x plus 6 degree plus 54 degrees equals to 180 degrees. 2x plus 3x is 5x and plus 6 plus 54 degrees, 60 degrees. This is equals to 180 degrees. Now we will shift 60 degrees to right hand side. So 5x equals to 180 degree minus 60 degree, which is 120 degrees. That means x is equals to 120 degrees upon 5, which is 24 degrees. This is the answer. This is question number 5, first part. Now these two are parallel lines. The transversal is cutting them. This angle is 60 degrees. You have to find x and y. Since x and 60 degree are vertically opposite angles, so x will be equals to 60 degrees because vertically opposite angles are equal. And x and y are corresponding angles, and so they are also equal to each other. That means y is also 60 degrees. The reason is corresponding angles. Now, second part of question number 5. These two are parallel lines. The transversal is cutting them. This is 135 degrees. So, what will be Q and what will be P? Q and 135 are vertically opposite angles. So, Q will be equals to 135 degree because vertically opposite angles are same. And Q and P are co-interior angles. That means P plus 135 degree, which we have found, which is Q. P plus 135 is 180 degree co-interior angles. So P will be 180 minus 135 degree, which will come out to be 45 degrees. Question number 5, third part. Now see children, A and 70 degrees. They lie on opposite side of the transversal and a Z is formed by them. See this A and this is 70 degrees. So these types of angles are called alternate angles, alternate interior angles, and they are also equal. So A will be equals to 70 degrees. Now A and B lie on a straight line. These are adjacent angles or a linear pair they form because they lie on a straight line. And the sum of the angles lying on a straight line is 180 degrees. That means A plus B equals to 180 degrees. Reason is they form a linear pair, or you can write adjacent angles also or straight angles also. So 70 degree plus B is 180. That means B is 180 degree minus 70 degrees, which is 110 degrees. Now fourth part I am going to do. Now children, X plus 128. X and 128 degree lie on a straight line. That means they form a linear pair. So X plus 128 degree equals to 180 degrees. They form a linear pair. So what is X? 180 minus 128 degree. So what comes out? 52 degrees. So what is the value of X? 52 degrees. Now X and Y are corresponding angles. That means Y equals to 52 degrees, same as X, because corresponding angles are same. Reason is corresponding angles. And similarly Z and 128 degrees are corresponding angles. Therefore Z is 128 degrees. Reason is same, corresponding angles. Now this is question number 6. Here three lines are given which are parallel to each other, AB, CD and EF. And the transversal are this. EC is the transversal cutting line EF and CD, and CA is the transversal cutting line CD and AB. You have to find the values of X and Y. If you consider these two parallel lines, 120 and X are co-interior angles. That means X plus 120 degrees equals to 180 degrees. So X is 180 minus 120, which is 60 degrees. And Y and 140 are also co-interior. So Y plus 140 degrees equals to 180 degrees. So Y becomes 180 degree minus 140, which is 40 degrees. Now, so what will be angle ECA? What will be angle ECA? This total, X plus Y. That means 60 degrees plus 40 degrees. That is 100 degrees. But in the question, they have asked to find the reflex angle ECA. Reflex means this one angle, this reflex. So, you know, total angle around a point is 360 degrees. this from here to here angle ECA, interior angle ECA is 100 degrees. So what is reflex angle ECA? 360 degree minus 100 degrees, that is 260 degrees.